I'll get busted for a copyright claim. But for the ears, for the mind, honey. So, oh, wow, someone gave a hug to another person. Wow, what's going on? So, time and consciousness. I'll give you few separate ideas and I'll let you connect the dots. If you can connect the dots, if you are in tune with this type of concepts, maybe some scientists are working on the theory. I don't know, I'm just tapping into the field. Tap. And I'm trying to put together a theory, but maybe someone else came up with the theory. Of course, they are simulation theory, the computer simulation theory, they are consciousness theories and all that, quantum field, a bunch of scientists or even people like myself, no scientists, no white coat, no glasses, no reading books, I don't read books. probably other people like me came up with some ideas. Other people are channeling, so sometimes I do channel. If you don't know what channeling means, probably you got in the wrong place. You are on my channel in the wrong place. Time is a program. So for us, let's say if we are a sort of a biological in our world, we are made to believe that we are made out of alive cells. Yes, we have cells, we have five senses, we have organs and stuff, and a functioning body that has life. And what's life? I tried to explain long time ago in another video. By comparing a dead body to an alive body and this life force and this complex energy that is being, you know, it's science behind it. The scientists are still trying to figure out what's life, how people get out of the body, how come they come back into the body while the body is dead. So anyway, that's a one aspect of this whole big program. And since you are a special energy program, energy in our world, but in the thought world, there is no, or a consciousness thought world, there is no energy. Energy is for us, so we can handle things from this layer, from the thought energy, atoms or matter, like a condensed form of energy, and then you condense it even further to become heavier. So from the matter it becomes even heavier, like black holes, like, right? So thought, it's something light. It's a form of energy as a field that it's very light. Then you condense the thought. It's like you focus the thought into something more localized. It's like you funnel more energy into a smaller space, like the earth. I'm just making an analogy to kind of get you thinking in the same tune. So you condensate this thought, so the thought is like that mind that's thinking is concentrating the power into something like into something that is flowing, is moving all the time, which is energy. It's an energy field, and that energy field, when you condensate it and you program it in a certain way, I mean, you don't have to condensate it like a squeeze the energy, but how to say it? It's part of the program, like the denser the energy, which is the energy programmed to become structured and denser. So that energy is structured anyway because it's part of the thought. The thought is like a program and has a structure. But if you condense it in a way like you program to have a density, then you make these structures that are heavier, like atoms and structures, and then it starts with atoms that are separated far away from each other, which you can get gas molecules and separate atoms just flying around, right? Different particles. Then when you condensate those, so you tell this program that creates this independent things, you adjust some numbers in the program, which are not numbers, even for us are numbers, but for the program itself, there is some sort of a like for in our world, it's a value, right? And that energy condensated, so you program the atoms, for our understanding, you program the atoms to get closer to each other, so you increase the gravity and the electrostatic forces of each atom. It makes them more compact, like heavier atoms. Just by switching some numbers, then you program those to have some interaction with other atoms, and you make these molecules and substance. Then when you increase the gravity, and then they get closer to each other, you make metals and rocks and stuff, and some solid structures, and this solid structure can make planets and other things, and it will increase the general force, the total force of the structure. And at some point, when the force is so big, it becomes a black hole, right? So that's a very condensated form of energy, a black hole that will pull everything inside. I got to my appointment, so I have to let go. So this program I have room here, yeah. This program, okay, so that gave you an idea. I have an appointment. But you, as a soul, you are another part of the thought. So that's like another piece of program. That's very complex. Of course, you know, since you are smart enough to understand stuff, that means you are pretty complicated. On top of your body energy, which is also another program, and so they decided to put you into a piece of program, which is your lifetime from here to here. And according to the creator knows your lifetime, when you start and when you finish, because you are into a slice of time. Even you are made to think that there is time from 1980s to 2000 something, it's a flow of time. But there is no time. It's just slices of events and programs that are all bunched up into the same space, or there is no space, in the same spot, like in the same chip in a computer. And you, as a program, you are made to think that it was a flow of events that gives you the feeling of time, time that is flowing, but actually there is no time. There is just a frame, a program you've been put into. And if you are wondering why is war, why is something, but how about your karma? You, as a program, you did something stupid, and now they decided to put you into a war zone, right? So you can kind of match the vibe, destruction, fear, or something like that. And sometimes they put you into, after, let's say, you die, all right? Which is another program. Death is a program. When your program, your soul comes out and it goes somewhere else in the field. And you go to a place where it matches your own programming, your karma, let's call it like that. And you see destruction, fear, or something. So you think, oh, that's a hell. Because you learn from another, you learn earlier as a program, you learn that this is the hell. Some people come back and they describe, so like some souls, some programs come back and they describe hell. And the only way to get out is call Jesus or maybe one of these deity, and they come and they rescue you. But you have to kind of make that pact that you are going to change. Same thing here, in this lifetime, in this frame. They installed you here, and if you have a good life, probably because who you are. If you have a bad life, probably you've done something before or it matches your internal thing. They stretch you to see who you really are. In, let's say, if you, they put you into a program where you have to chase food and make sure you are stay alive. It demonstrate yourself who you are. Like, are you going to kill your friend, your family for food, to feed your flesh, right? So Jesus was saying things in the Bible. Jesus was another special program, right? So if they put you into this time frame as a soul, they gave you the life from here to here. The creator already know when you die. You don't. You could kill yourself as a disconnecting from the body. You don't die as a soul, you don't die. But you disconnect from the body in a way that you kill yourself. So you, as a program, you decide, okay, I'm going to terminate this program, this life on earth. I don't give a crap. The thing is, before you came here, you made a pact with a creator, with a bigger thought, that you are supposed to do a job into a lifetime, which that frame, you are supposed to live from here to here, like a 60 years old or something. And if you break that pact, you get busted. You as a program, you are again getting put somewhere else, right? I don't know where, you should study that. But I gave you a couple of separate ideas. I have to go. See you later. Bye-bye.